Hello, my name is Kim, professor of Kalasangan University, India. Today's topic is third lecture for the properties of systems. Topic is time invariant and time variant. How to know the system is time invariant and variant. Okay, there is one system is here, impulse response. Output x over t produces output y over t like this through impulse response. And here, if we apply the signal which is shifted to the right, t minus t0 in input applied here, and if we get the signal which is also shifted to the right by t0 in output. Okay, then we call this time invariant system. For example, here the system input and output continuous time case. Now let me suppose input is this kind of system. This applied to here, then the, we get the okay, now this kind of signals we have. Then next we apply the signal which is shifted to the right by t0 in input also, like this. Okay, now this is here to here, t0 shifted. And also, we get the signal which is shifted to the right by t0 in the same output of this one. Okay, this kind. This is here to here, t0. Okay, then we call this time invariant system. Also, in case of a discrete signal case, also one input signal is, for example, this kind, this one, and this one input. Then if we get output is this one, this kind one, this one, this one, this one, this one. Okay. Let me suppose x of n is here. This kind of signal applied to this system, and if we get this one, this one. Then also, we apply the signal which is the shifted to the right by two, same signal, one, same signals just shifted to the right. Then also, if we get same shape of output, this kind, this one, this one. Then we call this also time invariant system. We call this. Okay. Therefore, for this, the signal which is shifted to the right by t0, then also we can, if we get the shifted by t0, then we call this time invariance, t minus t0, t minus t0 here. Okay, then how to know, how to check the system, whether the system is time invariant and the time variant. First, the right side signs, instead of xt, you can substitute xt minus t0. And left side, instead of yt, you can substitute yt minus t0. This is equation 1 and 2. Like this, the two questions are same, then we call this time invariant. Different, we call this time variant. For example, like this. For example, now x of t, y of t equal to x of t plus 1, right side, first of all, right half side, x instead of x of t, we can substitute x of t minus t0. Then we can get 2x t minus t0 plus 1. This is equation 1. Okay. Then next, left half side, instead of yt, we can substitute yt minus t0. Then yt minus t0 equal 2x, instead of t, now here, instead of t, you can use t minus 0, therefore x, t minus t0 plus 1. This is equation 2. Then now you can see here, you can compare the equation 1 and 2 is same. Therefore, we call this time invariant system. Okay. Next equation, system y of n equal n xn, n of xn. First, same as right half side, x of n instead of xn, we can substitute x n minus n0. Therefore, now this here, n x n minus n0. This is equation 1. Left half side, instead of y of n, you can use substitute y n minus n0. Therefore, y n minus n0 equal. Okay, now here. And instead of n, you can use n minus n0. Therefore, n minus n0 x n minus n0. This is equation 2. You can see, you compare this one. Equation 1, 2 is different each other. Different. Therefore, we call this time variant sheet. Okay. Next, okay. Y of t equal x square t, and means right half side, x of t, we can substitute x t minus t0. Therefore, x square t minus t0. This is equation 1. And left half side, instead of yt, we can substitute yt minus t0. Therefore, yt minus t0 equal, okay. Instead of t, you can t minus t0. Therefore, x square instead of t minus t0. This is equation 2. Then you can compare. Equation 1 and 2 is same, therefore, time invariant system. Okay, next, y of n equal x of n cosine omega n, also right half side. Instead of x of n, you can substitute x n minus n0. Okay, therefore, x n minus n0 into cosine omega n. This is equation 1. Okay, and the left half side. Instead of y of m, you can use y n minus n0. Therefore, y n minus n0. This means, I said many times, instead of n, you can use n minus 1. Therefore, n is here, n is here. Therefore, x n minus n0 and cosine omega n minus n0. This is equation 2. Then you can compare equation 1 and 2 is very, very different. Therefore, we call this time variant system. Okay. Next. Okay. Y of n equal x of n plus nx n minus 2. Also, right upside. Instead of x of n, you can substitute x n minus n0. Then x n minus n0 plus n x n minus n0 minus 2. This is equation 1. And left half side, instead of y of n, you can substitute y n minus n0. Therefore, y n minus n0. Okay, now this means, I said many times, instead of n, you can use n minus, you can substitute n minus n. Okay, equal x of, instead of n, n minus n0 plus also this is n is here, therefore n minus n0 here x n minus n0 minus 2. Okay, this is equation 2. Then equation 1, 2, we can compare this one, it's different, therefore this also time variant system. Okay, thank you so much for your watching. Today I lectured the third lecture of the properties of systems, how to know, how to check the time invariant and the time variant system. Next topic is the fourth lecture of the properties of systems, stable and unstable systems, and FIR and FIR systems. Please look forward to next lecture. Thank you very much.